So, just to continue on from that, that's done its calculations now. So, if I look around and turn that model off, you can see that the geometry from the high res is near enough the same. So, if I jump between these, so if I click on this model, the high res version, and turn that one off, you can see that detail that was in the high res is now projected onto the low res. So if I turn that off now, you can see the same detail on the low res. If I want to perfect this and get this even more right, I would play around with the distance settings, but I'm happy with the results I'm getting here right now. So if I put on a, just put a darker shader on just so you can see some of the detail here. So you can see that that detail has been moved across the skin, the wrinkles that you might have worked on earlier on, that's projected across. And the reason for that is the fact that you use the projection tool to kind of move that across. But one of the good things now is that we have all the subdivision levels. So if I move up and down, level 2, level 3, level 4, I have that detail. Now what we're going to do is we're going to move that detail back into Maya, and we can't do that in terms of the topology because the geometry is really high, and that was the first reason why we decided to retop this anyway. So if I put that to level 0, level 1, remember the geometry has to be on level 1 in order for you to bake the normal map. So if I move that to the lowest level and then go and click on, firstly on my UV map to specify the size that I want the texture or the normal map to be. Currently it's a 2K texture, which is 2048 by 2048. I'm happy with that. I minimize that and I'll hit my normal map menu open, click that. And the button that I'm going to press is, if I just hit create normal map and give it a few seconds, and you'll see that it's doing its calculations, and at the end of this I should get this a map. Now what this is looked at the high-res model and how light is being projected on the high-res model, and it creates a light map or what we call a normal map based on that. And that's why it's very important, what I said in the first video, is to have your UV maps. Now it'll be able to wrap this around the low poly version in Maya and project that information. So the light information on how the model looks in high res is being captured into this map, and this map then can be applied into the low poly model in Maya or any other game engine. So what we're going to do is we're going to clone this. So it's very important you hit clone, and then we're going to export this out. So if I go to texture here, first of all, I'm going to flip this vertical. The reason for this is because ZBrush automatically has everything flipped upside down. So if we want it to work, we must click flip V. So flip and then export. I'm going to export this into Lab6 folder again, and I'm going to just hit JPEG, and I'm going to call it normal map, and hit save. You can see that detail has been put into the map, so it's very important that your unwrap is done in a right way that gives it enough detail. And we'll talk about unwrapping UVs another time in another tutorial. So I can see that detail is there, so I'm going to hit OK. Now I'm going to move back into Maya. So I'm just going to, oh, I better not open that. I'm just going to open this up here and minimize this. So here's my model, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a new shader to this. Firstly, you can see that this is set to hard edge, and what I mean by that is just the way the shading is working, and the shading is set currently to hard edge. So if I go into my mesh display, and instead of hardened edges, I'm going to hit soften edge. And you'll see the thing that's changed is that it's made everything nice and smooth. Another thing that I usually like to do is, it's up to you if you want to subdivide the model, but because it is a fairly low poly model, I'm just going to subdivide this by one, level 1. So just hit that smooth option, and you can see everything's nice and smooth, so it's not super low poly. But if you don't want to do that, you can always also hit the 3 key, the shortcut, and kind of puts a temporary smooth on it as well, so you can see the detail on your model. In terms of applying a shader, I'm just going to hit rendering here, and I'm going to choose the blend option and let that and you'll see that you'll get a bit of shine on the model itself, so the blend material has definitely loaded up. So just to click back onto that model so we can see the material itself, one way you can find the material again is by opening up HyperShader and locating the material that way. The other way you can locate the material is if you select the model that it's attached on and go into your attributes editor and find blend. If you can't access your attribute editor, if it's not there, then just make sure you click on these buttons and it'll appear, and then you choose that material. So where we're going to load this map is inside the bump mapping menu. So if you load up the file, if you click on that and hit file, and I'm going to choose, make sure you switch this to tangent based bump map, space normal. When I click on that, I should be able to navigate and locate my normal map. So there it is. I'm going to hit open. You see that it's loaded that up, but nothing has happened here. So in order for us to see it, we of course have to activate the textured display. So if I click on that, you see that the normal map has loaded itself onto this. You're seeing that you're getting this seam and you're getting this problems. That's just the viewport that it's set to. You can change that, make sure that's working. If I go into here in the color space normal, sometimes this can work. So if I click on raw, it hasn't really fixed that problem for me at this stage. So just to see and view how our normal map is looking, I can also go into the renderer and go to legacy high quality viewport. And temporarily you can see from that the normal map projecting that low poly detail. So this is still a low poly version of the model, but the high res detail has now been moved into this. So if I just go into object, I should be able to see that. So that's showing that fine detail that we were talking about in this menu here. So if I hit the render view, turn that off and go back into legacy high viewport, that is now showing the detail on the low poly version of the model. So again, this viewport settings can be changed, and I will show you how to do that in another tutorial. So that's the main area that I wanted to talk about today. Was just that was the main tutorial for those people that missed it last week. That's what we did in class, but we did it as we went through the whole process stage by stage. And I would like everyone to attempt that either on their own models or with the example that I've given. So it's a good way to kind of get used to this process. You will be using it one way or the other. So do that. Thank you.